Today, an even greater threat is the threat posed by the Chinese Communist Party. It's not tanks and guns. It's very different from that. The CCP initiates retaliation against innocent parties when crossed. You all see this. The CCP leverages economic power to coerce countries. This is deeply inconsistent with each of our values. The CCP lies. It makes those who tell the truth disappear. The virulent pandemic that came from Wuhan spread so widely and caused so much damage because the CCP covered it up. The regime has a Marxist-Leninist core no less than the Soviet Union did, and indeed perhaps more so. The party has always put itself first. Its actions flow from its ideology, and it's paranoid about free societies like ours. What's happening now isn't Cold War 2.0. The challenge of resisting the CCP threat is in some ways much more difficult. That's because the CCP has already enmeshed in our economies, in our politics, in our societies in ways the Soviet Union never was. And Beijing is not likely to change course in the near future. No one thought the Berlin Wall would fall. We had no idea that in just a matter of weeks, people would be crossing freely back to be reunited with their families. Well, freedom will win this time, too. As President Havel once reminded us, we must commit not to live the lie, but to live in the truth. And here's what's true. China's world dominance is not inevitable. We're the authors of our fate. Free societies have always been more attractive. Your people know this. Our people do, too. And here's the best news of all, from all of that. The resolve of freedom-loving people all over the world is to defend their way of life, and it is growing. I see it every place I go. Americans now recognize that the CCP, which is totally separate from the Chinese people, threatens their values and their way of life. Both parties in Washington agree on very little. But on this, we all know what we're up against. The tide has turned. Just as I see it turning here in Europe as well. The West is winning. Don't let anybody tell you about the decline of the West. That is false. That is their narrative. But it's going to take all of us. It will take us working together here in Prague, in Poland, in Portugal. We have the obligation to speak clearly and plainly to our people and without fear. We must confront the complex questions presented by this challenge, and we must do so together.